Hello everyone, it is your friendly neighborhood Think Trap, Exos, and today I'm going to show you how to wrap your laptop in carbon fiber. Reason why I started wrapping my laptop in carbon fiber is that I would get laptops with scratches, nasty words on here, stickers, all this junk. This is a R400, and it isn't really in nice condition, but one thing I like to do is to hide it with carbon fiber wrapping, similar to like having Bondo onto a car. Here is another example of a lid that I have from a security plate right there. This thing is scratched really bad. If you don't want to buy a new lid, or if you want to preserve your lid, I suggest doing carbon fiber wrapping. It's not as easy as buying like a laptop skin, because you just place it right on there. You have to have a you have to have scissors, and you also have to have a razor blade for the most part. And if you have a needle to like sew with, you could probably get away with that in certain parts. But let me show you. Here is my X61. I've wrapped it on the edges, here and there. Only problem is that sometimes you might come across of it coming out. Here's another one. Here is my 831P. This one, I think I did a better wrap. This wrap came off a lot better. The edges aren't as bad. So I'm gonna show you guys how to do it. Today we are going to wrap this T410. It's in good condition, but there are little parts here and there that show wear. And also, it's not really that really nice looking here. So I'm gonna do a little wrapping on here, on the palm rest, the bezel, and most importantly, the lid. And we'll start off with that off first. I wanted to show you the two different types of wrap. There are 2D wrap, and there's also a 3D wrap. There's also a 4D wrap, but all it is just a 3D wrap with like a coating on top. This one right here, I bought at eBay. It's supposed to be like a 3M compatible. It's a ripoff of the 3M D-Knock, I believe. I think I spent like $24 for like a decent sized roll. I don't know if you can see, I used quite a bit of it. I probably wrapped already like four laptops, or maybe three laptops with this, and I still probably got like maybe at least one, two, maybe three if I'm lucky. So let's get to work. First things first, you gotta make sure that your area is clean. Make sure that there's no sticker residue or anything. Sticker residue, usually comes off with your finger. Gotta take off this sticker as well. Thank you, Energy Star, for being easy to take off. Spray some glass cleaner on there. You don't have to worry about it. Again, super, super clean. All right, the next step is to measure. Let's find out how big this thing will be. Also, I'm not sure if I'm gonna keep this wrap, but we're just gonna use it as an example. And I have to say, pick if you want to have the lines, which the diagonal way you want. And also, I have to find out if I have enough. I'm not even sure if I'm gonna even have enough for the keyboard, to be honest. So I can't have a odd mix match design. If I do that, make sure you get like that down from up there all the way to the lid, like that. Go ahead and make your line. I like to give myself extra space just in case. about, I'll just say right there. Draw your line that you're gonna cut. Get your scissors and cut it. Here comes the fun part, is applying it. And you don't have to worry if you mess up the first time with this. Usually it's very forgiving. Just make sure when you're taking it out that you don't make any creases on there, because you will see the crease when you apply it afterwards. I always apply a good amount on the a good overlap, I should say. It's a bit off right there. See, did I do enough? Pull it back all the way. In case there's any air bubbles. I'm just doing like a testing press. See, make sure. Do I have enough? Oh yeah. See, you got the bezel. You got the lid bezel right there. The ends right there. So I do. Then we're just going to one more time. Take this apart. Take this part out. There are some air bubbles. Next, we're going to just get our first cut in here just to make things go smoother. Just want to do a rough cut on the edge. Ooh, that's going to come out. You gotta be careful of me then on this part. You wouldn't have to worry about this if you do a better cut. Oh, so maybe this is a bad guide I'm doing. Let's see, let's find out. I like to always crease it with my finger now. Try not to cut the palm rest while I'm at it. Don't want that nasty gash in there. It looks like, oh dear, I messed up on that part. Should definitely do a preliminary test run on this. Where's this? Okay, there it is. Also, I think it might be a note to have a drawing of your ThinkPad right next to you, so you know what the design looks like. Because sometimes I cut too much, and I'll forget that there will be like a little antenna or something sticking out, and lo and behold, it will be gone. These ones I like to cut the inside hinge first, the inside part of the hinge. Just so you could You could possibly fold it on the inside. These hinges are kind of not that nice looking. They're not in a great condition. Crease, crease, crease. See, there's a bit of a bubble right here. We'll lift this thing up. I like to usually cut right here. Make sure there's no air bubbles at all. I like using digitizer sometimes. Just one more time over my fingernails. Alright, then you just cut and hope that you got it right. There goes that hinge. Now you're gonna see that cut forever. Then when that's done. Ooh. See, in these hinges, I'll do like a little side cut like that. You're probably never gonna have a perfect edge. Cut one more time. Cut this way. Alright, I'll deal with this later, but yeah, there we go. So that's one down. Alright, now it comes to the end. This end. What I like to do sometimes is to just try to cut that. See how there's a you see that little line? I just try to cut that line as best as possible. Let's see. You can kind of see the markings right there. Well, I can see it. I don't know if you can see in the video. Let it fold on one side, and then the other. And if there's any overlap, you can either keep it or cut it. But sometimes cutting it isn't the best idea, because you'll cut too much, and you're gonna see the laptop, so that's not always good. Again, crease it one more time. I like just doing the lids only because they're easy to do. And really, that's like the only part of the laptop that gets most wear. I mean, yeah, your keyboard gets more wear than the palm rest, I think. But some palm rests are pretty tough. So I don't like doing those. Looks like I took apart the bezel right there for a second. I think this thing has a bad bezel, LCD bezel, to be honest. Well, I think I cut too much. I have to say, the T60 is probably the easiest one to do this on. So do it on that. This one I'm going to do a little bit different. It's going to cut like this. Actually, I'm just going to cut it straight. Just cut a little bit so it could bend a bit. Let's see. Wrap it one part right there. And one part right here. Alright. Oh yeah. Looks good. Definitely. Pretty much the same process over and over again. Well, someone's popular today. Alright, let's cut it, or let's pull it out. Not good enough. Let's get this edge also. Sometimes it doesn't like tearing, so I wouldn't recommend this approach. And it'll tear ugly, just like right there. Alright, so that approach is a little bit ugly. I'll say you got a little bit overlap, but you might want to use that overlap, because if you have it like how I have it like this, it'll come out. So unless you're gonna put glue on there, that little overlap is nice, because it gives a good amount of area to grip to. Also, keep in mind, this usually takes about like 2 hours. I don't know how long it is for this video, but you're not gonna see the parts where I'm detailing the cuts, because even these cuts that I'm doing right now, they're not. You always end up seeing an imperfection here or there, and so you'll have to do some more cut fine tuning. I have no clue if this video is going to be all fuzzy. So there you go. That's the basic gist of it.